So welcome everyone for coming in here. My name is Eric from Dale Pro Audio. I've seen a bunch of your names on some of the other chats, so welcome back if you're coming back again. I'm Dale's Director of Marketing. And so today we have with us our friends at LEA Professional. They're gonna be talking about their amplifiers. We've also been graciously put this on by John B. Anthony, who represents them in the New York area. So we have Enrico Rotolo from JBA here. So some of you guys may have heard of LEA. LEA is a brand that came out a couple of years ago now, based on some great pedigree from other manufacturers coming along the way. And one of the things that's really cool about these amps, and we're going to get into that during the course of today's session, is these amps are practically only programmable and manageable via IP. And obviously in today's world, this is a really big issue that we're having, where people need to do stuff in socially distanced, work remotely, but you still have to keep an eye on, you know, your rig. So these amps are really timely in that they've come out to market at this time and have some incredible power and flexibility and real amazing feature sets that they're going to use. So I'm going to hand it over to Joey from LEA, and he's going to go through the entire set with us. So Joey, the floor is yours.
Well, thank you, Eric. We really appreciate it that you guys have asked us to be part of your AES show. And so thank you guys very much on behalf of all of LEA. We're excited. And so I'm Joey Polkowicz. I am the North American Sales Manager here at LEA. And first, I figured I'd just give you a quick intro to LEA. As Eric mentioned, it paved a great segue into our Connect Series amplifiers. And as Eric mentioned, we are the first to be an IoT cloud-enabled amplifier. So it's made the jobs much easier for many of our integrators that have taken the plunge and are using our amps, of course, you know, during our current global climate. So with that, just a quick backstory on LEA. So you may know most of us from Crown Audio. That's kind of where our heritage comes from. And so our founder and CEO is Blake Augsburger. And first and foremost, just to give you a backstory on the name. So Blake, our founder and CEO, has a boat in Florida, and his boat, so he's an avid sport fisherman, and so he calls his boat Loud Enough. And so we had a little bit of fun when we were trying to figure out the name for the company. So we called the company Loud Enough Audio. Then also too, being that Blake is an avid sport fisherman, we have our shark fin logo that you can see on my screen. So just a cool way of us really denoting Blake's hobbies. So we are a technology company. So even though we do create and build amplifiers right now, we do purpose ourselves as a technology company. And so, you know, a lot of what you'll see today too will likely pave the way into other platforms as well in the future. So we launched the company, we went public in January of 2019 at WinterNAMM. And so we have been shipping products. We actually started working on the initial design of our Connect Series amplifier in June of 2018, and then we started shipping in October of 2019. And shortly after that, of course, Dale took the plunge, and they now also stock our amplifiers. So we're very happy to be a partner. So to give you a quick rundown of the people that are in the company. So Blake Augsburger, of course, is our founder and CEO, and just a quick history on Blake. So Blake started in the industry in 2000, where he became the president of Crown International. And so for the next 6 years, he ran Crown International, did very well with it, grew the business substantially, grew it to a little over $100 million in 2006. And he was then promoted to executive vice president and president of Harman Pro. So at the time in 2006, Harman Pro, I believe, had 8 or 9 brands in the portfolio. And over the next 10 years, Blake grew it from roughly a $500 million business to a $1.1 billion business in 2016, which then he decided to depart Harman and go into a partial retirement. So, you know, Blake wasn't quite sure what he wanted to do during that time. So spent a lot of time sport fishing, of course, and playing a lot of golf. There after that in 2017, as you may or may not know, Harman was acquired by Samsung. And so there was some restructuring that took place. One of the components to that restructuring, I forgot to mention, we are based in Salton, Indiana. So of course, working for Crown, Crown was in Elkhart, Indiana, which is about 20 minutes from where I sit here in our headquarters. But Crown was shut down in 2018, and part of the restructure was to take and move engineering to China and then manufacturing to Mexico. So Blake saw it as an opportunity to start back up in the industry. And so he hired 10 of the best Crown engineers who he hand selected, as well as the leadership team that you see here on my slide. And you know, we started what we now call LEA. So it's a pretty cool heritage. And with that, we have over 200 years of combined experience inside of the pro audio industry. So, you know, again, we're not new to the industry. And, you know, it's just really cool because we all were able to come in and start on the ground floor and build the company and, you know, change things that we knew that needed attention. And so we really have created a very unique product as well as service as well. So to break down a little bit more, just in terms of some of our key partners, so where we manufacture, we actually have a partner called Zollner Electronics. And so Zollner is a German renowned ISO contract manufacturer. So they currently manufacture in the automotive as well as aerospace industries. So they actually do a lot of the electronics components for Tesla automobiles, as well as they do some components for SpaceX. So when you talk about quality, I mean, they come in second to none. They measure quality in parts per million. So they've been an extremely valuable partner. We have been very happy with everything that we've seen come out of their plant. Even though they are German renowned, we actually manufacture in one of their world renowned plants inside of Costa Rica. We did that intentionally. First and foremost, when we manufacture in Costa Rica, there's no tariffs with the US, trade free, duty free. But also too, it takes us a lot less time to get product into the USA versus most of the manufacturers that manufacture in various parts of Asia. Now, we can typically have products in a week once it ships from the factory. And then we also ship product daily as we bring the product into our warehouse here in Elkhart, Indiana, which happens to be only a few blocks away from where Crown Audio used to be. And so we're here in the Midwest, and we can ship products just about anywhere in the country within a couple of 3 days. So we're very centrally located. And then, of course, Dale stocks product as well. So they can get product out to you even quicker. So that's just a quick overview on LEA and who we are. So next is our products, and that's really the fun part. So we have our Connect Series amplifiers. And, you know, our Connect Series amplifier is really kind of the Swiss Army knife of amplifiers. You know, it is a full install amplifier, so it's made to be mounted in a rack and used and abused. You know, it'll take whatever you can throw at it. Being that it's an install amplifier, there's no knobs or buttons on the front panel. We just have our shark fin logo that you can see on my slide, as well as our LCD screen and our status indicators. You'll notice we have two grills, which are removable magnetic grills on the front panel of the amplifier. You can actually pry very gently on either one of the sides of the grill, and it will pop those off, and our filter is actually housed inside the grill for very easy filter cleaning. All of our amps are in a 1U design that we're currently shipping, so our smallest wattage unit, which is an 80-watt unit, up to our highest powered unit, which is a 700-watt unit, all fit in this 1U form factor. And so, you know, traditionally, one of the things that is not so good when you put it in a 1U form factor is you typically lose space in terms of depth of the amplifier. One of our closest competitors, PowerSoft, as an example, they typically operate in a much deeper rack space, around 19 inches. LEA, we actually operate in a 14.25-inch rack deep cabinet space, so we can fit in even the shallowest of cabinets. On top of that, we have two different variants of our amplifiers. So we have a Dante Connect series as well as a Network Connect series. The only difference between the two models is that the Dante Connect series supports both Dante and AES 67. and the Network Connect series does not. So it does everything else that the Dante model does, minus Dante and AES 67. Why do we call it the Connect series? So we call it the Connect series because there are three ways to connect into the amplifier. So the first option you have to connect into the amplifier is using just a standard LAN connection, so a Cat 5 or Cat 6 option. The second option you have is using venue Wi-Fi, or we also have a built-in access point on our amplifier. So again, really with flexibility in mind, you know, this gives you the option where maybe you're deploying our amps in a new install and it might be an early construction phase. You can go in and you can engage our access point, and then you have a one-to-one relationship with either your phone, tablet, or computer to go in and configure the amplifier, set it all up. And so once a network does become present, when it gets further on in the construction phases, you just power our amps up and they're ready to go. You don't have to send a tech back out on site. So all of our amps, in terms of control and monitoring, there's basically three different ways that we can control and monitor. So the first way is our web app UI, which you see a screenshot here of on my slide. This is all browser-based, so everything's served up out of the browser. There's no apps to download. Our second option is using our cloud platform, which we just launched in June. So this will gives you the ability to let you operate remote virtually anywhere in the world. And same thing, that is also a browser-based platform. And then the third option we have is we do have some APIs, which we'll talk about after I give you a live demo of our web UI and our cloud platforms. So in terms of model numbers, just a quick breakdown. So you can see, again, we have our two different series, our Dante Connect series, as well as our Network Connect series. There's 20 SKUs in total in our lineup. We are shipping 16 of those 20. And so how our breakdown works is we start out, we have an 80 watt by 4 and 8 channel. We have 160 watt by 4 and 8 channel. We have a 350 watt by 2 and 4 channel, and then a 700 watt by 2 and 4 channel. And so all of those are in that 1U design that I just showed you on the slide before this. And then sometime in 2021, we are going to introduce our high powered units, which is our 1500 by 4 channel, and then our 3000 watt by 4 channel. The major difference there is those units will be in a 2U design. And those will be our high horsepower amps, where if you need to drive a big line array or something of that nature in an arena or stadium, you'll have plenty of power to do that. One thing to note, we try to be very simplistic in everything that we do here at LEA. Part of why I also love working here. But as you take a look at our model numbers are very simplistic. So if you look at the top, this Connect 84D, we do our model numbers in such that it's always wattage followed by channel count. So the 8 stands for 80 watts and the 4 stands for the channel count. And then D just denotes Dante. So the network models follow the same suit, minus they don't have the D for Dante. Something else important to point out is that we can drive any load on our amps. So we can drive anything down to a 2-ohm load and anything up to a 70 volt or 100 volt load. And that is also selectable per channel. So you can have each individual channel set for a low Z load or high Z load. It doesn't matter. You set that accordingly in the web UI or our cloud. So to break down our feature set a little bit more, we use a universal switch mode power supply in all of our amplifiers. So we operate anywhere from 85 volts AC all the way up to 277 volts AC. So the nice thing is, if you do install the amp and, you know, maybe you have a brownout condition, well, there's no clicks or pops on the output stage of our amplifiers. They will automatically adjust themselves and scale accordingly at full rated output power and spec. We guarantee that as long as you maintain the 85 to 277 volts. We also have something called advanced power factor correction. And so one of the main things that is really in our heritage and our DNA is, you know, just having a great sounding amplifier. So we've invested a lot of time and money to, you know, to make it do exactly what it's supposed to, make little signals bigger and sound great while it does that. So with our advanced power factor correction design, you know, what this really works at is the efficiency of the amplifier. Our amps are a Class D amplifier. So traditionally with power factor correction, one of the byproducts that power factor correction introduces is some harmonic distortion or some switching distortion down the signal chain. So what we've actually done in our advanced design is we take two PFC circuits and we put them directly out of phase of one another. So they cancel each other out, or they cancel out the harmonic distortion that is caused by traditional power factor correction. So what this does for us is it gives us the efficiency we're looking for. We operate in the mid 90% plus efficiency rating on all of our amplifiers, as well as when you take a look at the THD value on our spec sheet for distortion, it's a very, very low THD value. So we're keeping that signal integrity very, very clean. Probably one of the coolest features to our amplifiers is a feature that is proprietary to LEA, and this is called Smart Power Bridge. So what Smart Power Bridge does is it's unlike traditional bridging where you take channel one and channel two on an amp and you tie them together to double your power output by bridging them. With Smart Power Bridge, what I do is I can actually go into our web UI or our cloud and I can engage Smart Power Bridge on any single channel at one time. So let's just say I have our Connect 354, which is a 350x4 channel. If I go in and I engage Smart Power Bridge, let's say on channel two, I double the power, so I get 700 watts, and I don't sacrifice any other channel. So channel one, three, and four remain live at rated output power. So it's a pretty unique feature in such that, you know, it's very flexible. So, you know, maybe you have an application where maybe you need a subwoofer to be put in, and you don't have quite enough amp on your other channels to install that subwoofer. You know, you need some extra power for it. So you can just engage Smart Power Bridge and you still have all of your other zones, because maybe you need all those other zones for that install without tying up another zone for that subwoofer. Or if you're thinking about a big distributed install, same thing on a high Z load, you can also engage Smart Power Bridge and you have double the power if you have a very large zone somewhere that you need to put a bunch of speakers down line. So it's very flexible and it's unaffected whether it's a high Z or low Z load, which is great. In addition, we do have full DSP. So we have some onboard limiters, speaker limiters. We have parametric EQ, delay, crossover settings, and a bunch of other really cool features like real-time load monitoring, event monitoring, and fault monitoring. So I'm actually going to show you what those look like here next. So for our web UI, I want to give you a demo of that. So basically, what you'll do to get set up on the web UI is that you connect the amplifier to the network, or you engage our AP mode, so one of the three ways that we talked about to connect into the amp. And what happens, the amplifier on the front panel LCD will actually assign itself its own IP address. So with that IP address, defaults DHCP out of the box. And so all that I do is I take that off the front panel and I pop it into my browser, whatever browser you prefer, and hit enter, and then it serves up our web app UI. Again, there's no apps to download. So the web app UI is very intuitive. You start out, and this is the mobile view, of course, so you start out with the amplifier where you click into the amp. On the mobile view, you'll see it takes you into your channels, so you select what channel you want to work on, and then we have our navigational icons. Now, the great part is here is you can never get too in-depth into the web UI and not be able to find your way back out, so it's very easy. As long as you have even very basic audio signal flow knowledge, you can navigate the menus extremely efficiently. So I want to show you what that looks like. So here I have Dale's website pulled up. So how I would get into my web UI is all that I'll do is go ahead and I have my amp sitting on my desk here. So I just take and I type in my IP address, which happens to be 10.8.2.169. And then I hit enter and it serves our web UI right up out of the browser. So first you'll notice we have a bunch of amplifiers. Since I'm here at LEA headquarters in Salpin, Indiana, we have engineering amps, we have sales, marketing amps, all of that in the left-hand pane. So as I'm scrolling down through those, I just find whatever amplifier I want to work on. And what we're doing as a side note is we use a self-discovery mode. It's a UDP discovery mode, so it'll display any amp with a single IP address. So I find the amp I want to work on. and I click into it. And then you can see, just like in the screenshot right before this, we have our navigational icons at the top. And we also have, you can see, full metering capabilities. I'm just pushing some program music through my amplifier right now, so you can see how well our meters work. Everything is very, very responsive in the web UI. And just to give you a quick overview, I'll run you through these icons briefly and tell you a little bit about what they do. So first and foremost, we have on channel one, I'll run through our input matrix menu. So at the top here, we have a channel mute. You can see it mutes here and here on the amp. We also have our output fader. You can see everything is also very quick as I'm playing around with it. And then there's a primary and secondary input. So on the primary input, you have your input fader, of course, and then we support a routable input matrix on all of our amplifiers. So you can take and you can route any input to any channel or zone. And that also is true for the Dante models. So this is actually a network model. So you see my analogs here. But if this were the Dante model, you would actually have all of your Dante inputs labeled right below your analogs. So after I select my input, I set my sensitivity. And the secondary just mirrors the primary input. So I set all those settings, same thing. It's a routable input matrix here on the secondary. And so what we've given you the ability to do is we have a couple different override modes. So, you know, say maybe you're installing these amplifiers in an application where you have a paging system. We actually just completed a Crocs install for a warehouse for Crocs shoes. And so they have a paging system in that warehouse. And so what they did is they hook it up to the secondary input, and our amplifiers have built-in internal ducking. So what happens is upon sensing a paging signal come in, the amplifier will automatically duck the primary program. You make the page, and then it reverts back over to the program music once the page has been completed. Or with the second option, this is a signal sensing override or a failsafe. So if you wanted to set a Dante as your primary, you could have an analog signal routed back as your secondary to the same source. So if the Dante ever failed out, you would always have program music present. Next up's channel settings. So here you can do cool things like name channels. You see I've named these here. And then I mentioned our amps have selectable high Z and low Z settings. So I can go in and I can select a low Z or high Z load. Maybe I need 70 volts on channel one. Maybe I need a low Z load on channel two. That's as quick as it is to do, about a click of a mouse. Down from there is our smart power bridge. So right now you can see on this particular amplifier, this happens to be a 700 watt by four channel. I have channel four enabled. So I'm getting double the power out of channel four, and all these other channels are remaining live and open. At any time I can go in and say I needed channel two, you know, say channel two is my subwoofer, like I have it labeled here. Well, I just click into channel two. Channel two is now engaged with smart power bridge. Channel four comes out, and so I'm doubling the power on channel two now. The great thing here is that you don't have to flip any dip switches, rewire anything on the back of the amplifier. It's all done through our software. Next is a signal generator. So we give you pink noise, white noise, and tone for testing purposes. And of course, you can adjust the tone however you want to. We have a crossover menu. So with our crossover menu, there's a couple of nice features at the top here, our export and import functions. So if I wanted to, I could get all of my channel one settings set up inside the amp, and then I can take and export this file. It'll export a JSON file, and I can re-import that into any other channel across this amp or other amplifiers. So I don't have to redundantly go in and set those amplifiers up. I can also take in, once I set up this entire amp, I can export the entire amp file, and then I can re-import that into other amplifiers if I'm deploying multiple amps in a venue and they're all getting the same settings. We do have built-in delay, so we have up to 100 milliseconds of delay on all of our amplifiers. You can input the value here or, of course, fine-tune it with these up and down arrows. Polarity, you can flip that on the fly per channel here in the web UI. As a side note, too, on all of our connectors, both input and output, we actually silk screen polarity on all of those. So it makes it very easy as you take the connector away in a rack, you can wire up the connector and always know that it's wired up properly. We do have high and low pass filters with all your favorite flavors. So we have Butterworth, Linkwitz, Riley, and Bessel filters on board. You can set those accordingly and the filter slopes. There's 8 bands of parametric EQ per channel. So here we have gain, frequency, and Q factor adjustments, as well as high and low pass shelves between 6 and 12 dB per octave as well. There's onboard speaker limiters. So, you know, depending on whatever your favorite speaker manufacturer is, typically all that you would do is you can hop on the manufacturer website and grab the spec ratings off from the spec sheet, the wattage ratings, I should say. Or we also have a speaker limiter calculator on our blog page on our website, where you can pop in the wattage ratings of the speaker, and then it'll spit out these values so you can just drop them in your limiters to make sure that you're never overdriving that speaker. And then lastly is 2 different types of real-time monitoring. So being that it is an IoT cloud-enabled device, we monitor over 500 different parameters inside of our amplifiers. So load monitoring happens to be one of those. So essentially here, what we're doing is we're setting a low and a high limit. Depending if you're running low Z or high Z, you adjust that and set that accordingly. And in the event where you have, say, maybe a speaker blowout or a speaker dropout, we will give you a timestamped event of that. So you were probably wondering what these emojis do here on all of our amplifiers. These actually give you the report of any one of those events, as we call it, or faults. So anytime that you do have an event or fault, this emoji will actually turn from a smiling face to a frown face. And then you could click into it to see what's actually happening inside of the amplifier. So of course, these are all smiling, but if I go here to my menu, I could go to events or faults. And then here you can see what that timestamp log looks like that the amplifier keeps anytime you have one. We also have a pilot tone detector as well. So here, if you're deploying this in maybe a life safety application or even a live venue and you need to guarantee intelligibility of the system, we can send an inaudible tone downline between 18 kilohertz and 22 kilohertz. So in the event on a big distributed system, you do have a speaker dropout, this will again give you an event anytime that occurs. So that's it for the icons on the top. We do have light mode and dark mode, so I can switch between those. And then there are some other icons as well. We have this power icon that gives you things like line voltage and current that we monitor. We have auto standby settings in our amplifiers. So if you want to adjust this accordingly, if the amp doesn't receive a signal above the threshold that you set for more than the time that you set here, the amplifier will go into a sleep mode. So the great thing is about this is that you can wake our amplifiers back up almost instantaneously out of auto standby, as well as you still have full ability to report and monitor on everything while it's in auto standby mode. And we consume very, very little power draw in auto standby mode. The next icons are network settings menu, so our 3 ways to connect. If you're doing any type of government install, you can take and disable our access point so you're not generating any type of Wi-Fi signal. The speaker, of course, is a global channel mute. And then we also have our green power menu here. So we measure things like power usage as well. And then we have another feature that we're currently working on, which is power over Ethernet. So once this feature is enabled, with an LEA amplifier, you'll be able to take and hook them up to a PoE switch that's on a battery backup. And in the event that you lose AC main power voltage in the install, we have the ability to do what our engineers call reporting from the grave. So with this, what we can do is we keep the network card live and we monitor back on all the sensors inside the amplifier. So things like internal heat, channels, AC line voltage, all of that. Actually, we can give you the exact time you lost AC main power voltage. So, you know, you're always in the know about what actually happens downline. And so that's it for the web UI. There's of course many other functions, but for the sake of time, I wanted to give you a quick overview of that. And so a couple other things that I did want to show you. We do have some open APIs here. So essentially, we are able to communicate with various other manufacturers. So whether that be QSIS, we have a plugin for QSIS. We have our Crestron APIs, Extron, the Atlanta Velocity driver, as well as we just released the Barco Overture driver. You can also see the other companies that we are also working with, which will be available soon. And we have some open APIs as well. So if you have a manufacturer that you like to use that you don't see on this list, we can typically communicate with those as long as they use simple TCP or WebSocket commands. So the last thing that I'll show you is our cloud platform. And this is probably the coolest part because, you know, everything that I just showed you in the web UI is also available via our cloud platform. And the best part is once you buy an LEA amplifier, there's no additional charges to what you'll see today for our cloud platform. It's all free. Same thing, our cloud is served up out of the browser. So you just go to leaprofessional.cloud and then you have full remote access from anywhere virtually in the world. And one of the great things too about our cloud is we're the only ones that are doing an actual true cloud platform with amplifiers. So when you think about your customers that you're serving, you know, many of those may not want you inside of their venues or just be able to, you know, monitor things while people are not in the venue. This gives you all of that capability with our amps. And so it becomes a very, very powerful tool. Because we can actually set up different venues. So each time you do an install in a venue, you set that up and you then have this dashboard where you can go in and monitor and control any of your venues. So the quick backstory on our cloud platform is that we use Amazon Web Services or AWS IoT Core to be specific. So the reason we chose AWS, there's actually several, but first and foremost, when you're talking about the cloud is security. So AWS IoT Core uses a 256-bit SSL security encrypted protocol. So it's very secure. You know, as you go out and talk to system IT managers and you're telling them about our amps, when you say AWS, you usually get a very positive acceptance. Of course, it has the ability to grow as you grow with the amplifiers, as we grow, as well as in the future, we will have custom paid for versions. If you need like advanced analytics or other type of security protocols, we can offer that in the future. In terms of global reach, so, you know, whether you're monitoring your client's install on a daily basis, weekly, whatever your service contract may call for, or, you know, maybe you're on vacation, say in Bora Bora on the other side of the world, you can log in remotely and have full access and control if you were to get a call from your client and they wanted to know what was happening or if you could check something in the audio path for them. So, you know, basically where we're going here is that with our cloud platform, this really gives you the ability to help you sell maintenance and service contracts to your clients and be a differentiator. Now, we want to give you the ability where you can add another line item to that service contract, where you now have the ability to remote control and troubleshoot your client's devices anytime 24/7. And as we all know, you know, the reoccurring revenue piece is of course always a nice piece, especially these days. So it keeps you safe, keeps your clients safe, as well as, you know, gives some nice revenue on a monthly basis. And so with that, I want to go ahead and switch over and show you what our cloud platform entitles. And so I have our cloud platform pulled up. I just went to the website, so leaprofessional.cloud. And the only thing that you need is an email and password to set up a cloud account, of course, besides an LEA amplifier. So here at the bottom, all that I would do if I'm at leaprofessional.cloud is click register new account, and then that's where you put in your credentials. I believe what happens the first time after you click register, we do send you an authentication email with a passcode. And after you access that passcode, then you have full access into our cloud. So I have the cloud set up here. So I'm going to go ahead and get signed in. And so the big thing that you'll notice is, as I mentioned earlier, we have venue level groupings now. So you can see, you know, there's a bunch of different venues that I have set up across my cloud account. And I can just scroll through those venues very easily and see, you know, what venues are doing what. Of course, here's my venue. So I have our emoji, which we pull out from our web UI, where whether you have one amplifier or whether you have 500 amplifiers inside of a venue, that emoji will give you a quick and easy status indication across all those amps. So even if one amp is having an issue, this will display that. As well as we have a green sidebar here now because all my amps are online. But if an amp drops offline, the sidebar will turn red to let you visually know that, you know, you have an amp offline. I can go up to the top as well, and maybe I'm doing a quick, you know, daily scroll through for my clients. I can go in and I can actually go and sort by error status to see if any of my venues are having an error. And it'll take any of those venues up to the top so you don't have to scroll through, you know, maybe your 500 or 1,000 venues that you might have in your cloud account. Or I can also go in and I can search as well. So it's very simple. So what we'll do here, we'll go ahead and we'll create a new venue. So let's just call this, you know, Dale's venue. And so I will click add venue, and then you will see it pulls in Dale's venue here. Very simple. From there, because there's no amps inside the venue, I need to start building the venue out. So I click into it, and then there is this button called add amplifier. So I click on add amp. And what happens with AWS is they generate a security token that you see right here. And so I take and copy this security token, and then I head back over to my web UI, and I go and find the amplifier that I want to onboard into my cloud account. So inside the web UI, when I find the amp, I go to the eye icon, and I go to connect amp to account, and I take and paste that token and then click register. So what happens is with AWS, it goes through an authentication process. So you can see the amplifier connection was a success here. And so I'll head back over to my cloud itself. But over the next several seconds, all the way up to 2 minutes, it goes through this authentication process that does some handshakes with AWS just to do all the verification of the amplifier and make sure that everything checks out on the server. And so essentially what will happen then is it'll take and onboard the amplifier into the actual venue that you've onboarded it into. And you have full control and monitoring capabilities of the amplifier inside of that venue where you can go through and make all of your control and adjustment remotely. One thing I don't think I mentioned, there's no VPN. You don't need a VPN inside AWS. You also don't need any computer that's on site or that you have to remote into. All this is served up right out of the web. So from there, I'll go ahead. My amp is now here, as you see it appeared. And so I can click into that amplifier. And now I have full control and monitoring capabilities inside of the cloud. So I'm going to pull this out real quick, and I'm actually going to put these in two different windows so you can see a couple of things here. On the right-hand side, I actually have our cloud, and on the left-hand side, I have our web app UI. So I'm going to go to the same menu on each one of these. You can see I have exactly the same navigational icons. So you'll notice as we look through the channels, everything is the same. You see all of my meters do work. It's actually switching over to a new song right now, but you'll see the meters pop back up. So you can see things like level. You have mute control. If I go in here and I snap this fader on channel one, you'll see it pushes over into my web UI. Same thing if I go and mute a channel, you can see it pushes over virtually instantaneously as well. And it is two-way. So if I unmute from the web UI, it pushes back over into the cloud platform. So as you can imagine, you know, as you go through these menus and need to make any adjustments or, you know, check something, you know, maybe generate a pilot tone that you have a guy on site that's trying to test speakers, it makes it very, very easy for you as the installer with our cloud platform. The only difference in the cloud is that when you're in the cloud itself and you go to click on your network menu, we do lock you out. It's a read-only write in the network menu. And the reasoning behind this is that we want to make sure that you don't accidentally kick yourself off the network and you might be thousands of miles away. So we make that read-only when you're remote. But that is the only real difference between the cloud and the web UI. All right, So I'll finish up here. I have one last thing to talk to you about, and that's the LEA way. So that's the way that we do business. And I believe I mentioned at the beginning of this, we have over 200 years of combined experience inside the industry. So, you know, a lot of that experience just comes with mistakes that we've made, mistakes that we've seen others make. And that's really how we try to develop a better way of doing business. So our business model is pretty simple in that our customer is our is the system integrator or the distributor. And so we feel if we can give you an unparalleled support system as a manufacturer, you then in turn can do that for your customer who's the end user. So of course, our support with Dale and John B. Anthony is such that, you know, they support us and help support you. And we see that as the perfect business model. You know, we don't go around our integrators to try to have a direct relationship with the end user. That's not what we're about here at LEA. Also too, our warranty is very, very simple. So we have a 6-year warranty on all of our products. So we try to back our products and stand behind those because we are a new company. So for a warranty, how it works in the first 3 years is an advanced replacement warranty. If you have any issues with your amplifiers, you can get a hold of Dale. And basically what happens from there is they send you a brand new amplifier with a call tag to send the old amplifier back. And then for the remaining 3 years, it's a free parts and labor warranty. So it's one of the best warranties in the industry. What I will say to that is that we've had hundreds of integrators and partners all over the world take the plunge and try LEA. And we've pushed out now well over 3,000 amplifiers. We've had extremely good quality on all those amplifiers. And for all of the integrators that have tried us, you know, we are now seeing repeat purchases in multiples, meaning that we've become the brand of many of those integrators out there. So, you know, it's been a very solid product. We've had very, very good reviews written. We have a case study section on our website that talks about that, as well as we've received other reviews on things like LinkedIn. And the last thing that I'll say too is we have a very strong tie-in with the consultant community. We have our own internal guy that focuses directly on the consultant relationships. So LEA is now landing on specs all over the US and world. We actually just passed over 100 consultant agencies that are now specing LEA. So we're very excited about it. And that's all that I have. So with that, Eric, I don't know if you wanted to open it up for questions.
I am indeed back. Thank you very much for that, Joey. So yeah, if any of you guys have a question, you can unmute yourself or you can just type it in the chat and I'll read it out loud for Joey if you prefer. I'll take whichever you want. So if anyone has any questions, fire away. You did a wonderful.
Yeah, and while we're waiting.
See, look at that.
Yeah, it usually means I either did a great job or a terrible job, and no one knew what I was talking about. So hopefully it's the first one, right?
Well, hopefully this is a very timely subject since obviously, you know, doing site surveys and site maintenance is not exactly the easiest thing to do in the world right now.
Definitely.
I'd also like to mention too, if somebody's local to New York or New England, I, under the correct circumstances, am available to demo an amp if needed.
Yes. Yes, he is. And we appreciate that. And again, echoing what Joey said earlier, we do have pretty much the entire line. I think we have at least one of each model currently in stock on our shelves. I just put the link into the chat if anybody wants to take a look at what we got. But we have quite a few of them. We have some of the 2-channel ones, a couple of the 4-channel. So, you know, we do have a lot of them in stock, ready to go. So, you know,
definitely.
Probably very timely doing installs like this because, again, you can perpetuate your service with them. You know, if any of you on the list here do installs of that nature. So,
and both Network and Dante too, I know you guys have, Eric, so you know, whatever the install calls for, you guys should be able to get them taken care of. But we've actually seen a mix of both, you know, both have been extremely popular amplifiers, both Network and Dante. So Once you get familiar with it, it's a very, very simple amp to use.
Absolutely. So just one last call, though. We are raffling off an Imp 2 from Whirlwind. That's another brand that John B. Anthony handles for us. I just pasted the link one more time into our chat. So if you line over to our chat and click in there, enter to win an Imp 2. So unless anyone else has any questions, or if you have any other thing you want to add to Enrico, I see we also have our illustrious owner has joined us, Valerie Lager.
Hey, Valerie.
Hey, Valerie.
Valerie is hard at work in our office, keeping us going through these times.
Hi. Sorry. Got a phone call. How are you? How's it going,
guys? I'm doing well.
Okay, great. Good. Great. Thank you. I actually
Glad
think
you
I
could jump on.
Very cool. Very cool.
Good.
Thank you.
Good hearing from you. And just wanted to say as well, thank you to the entire Dale Pro team for having us today. We're very appreciative of it. And we love what you guys do.
Eric and Joel really put it all together. So we appreciate it. Thank you.
We do appreciate it. Any last call from any questions of the attendees?
They called me. All right. Okay. Okay, guys. Have a good rest of the show and a good day.
You too.
Okay. Thank you.
Thank you. You too.
Okay. Any other questions? I'll wrap it up. Guess not. All right. Well, I'll wrap it up then. So I appreciate Enrico for helping us put this together. Joey, thank you so much for your time. Any other questions? You know how to find us. You know how to find John B. Anthony. You know how to find LEA. We're all here for you. And we'll see you at the next session then.
Yeah, thanks for having us.